Happy Thursday, everybody. I pray all is well. My name is Michael Gibson, and I'm talking about why I go to church. If you've been following me any length of time, you would have known that I'm talking about, you know, why I go to church. I'm gonna share this out real fast, and then I'm gonna get started. And I pray everybody is just having a blessed day. I pray all is well with everyone. All is well with me. And I'm just, you know, excited to be able just to briefly share, you know, some of the things that God has placed on my heart. As I'm calling this, He Keeps Doing Great Things. Sometimes in life, it's easy to forget what God is doing for you. It's easy to just allow your circumstances to dictate to you, to allow your environment to dictate to you. But when you are a believer, it's imperative that you understand that your job is always to be the thermostat and not the thermometer. Your job is to be the thermostat and not the thermometer. And too many times we get stuck in being the thermometer. Everyone knows, or I hope everyone knows, what a thermometer is. But in just in case you don't know, let me explain what a thermometer does, the purpose of a thermometer. What a thermometer does is the thermometer, it senses the temperature. The thermometer evaluates the temperature of the room. If the room is hot, it'll tell you that the room is hot. If the room is cold, it'll let you know that the room is cold. However, the thermostat sets the temperature. There is a difference. One is merely reading what is happening to him, and the other is making it happen. I'm calling this that He keeps doing great things. There's a song that says, "He keeps doing great things for me." It's important to work or be with people that celebrate you and not tolerate you. I'm in transition right now. I've changed jobs, and I can see the difference of being somewhere where someone merely just tolerates me, but they're not really celebrating you. And the reason why I say that He keeps doing great things, and the reason why I mentioned the thermostat and the thermometer, sometimes when you're walking in life, you don't always know what God is doing. But you must understand that He will give you the desires of your heart. However, the desire of your heart, you don't always know the path that it takes to get to the desire of your heart. When I got a revelation of that scripture that God will give you the desires of your heart, I thought when I was young that anything that I wanted to have in my life, God would bring to me. But as I got older, I realized that as I got closer to God, as I began to feast and dine on His word, I came to the understanding and the revelation that God actually places the desire in my heart. He's the one that tells me that I should go forth and do His will. He is the one that is actually causing the open visions and the dreams. And I'm not talking about something deep. I'm just talking about basic things. When you get in your heart and your mind, "I'm better than this. I can do more than this. I deserve more than this." It's difficult sometimes when you know that the people around you are not a champion of you. But when you believe the voice of God, you go forward. You may be in a position where you are being devalued, and the people don't appreciate your work. And sometimes, yes, there's a level of accountability that one must take to bring themselves up to the standard. But other times, the person that is judging you is not equipped to understand you. The person that is over you is not equipped or qualified to judge your many talents. Because a lot of people that are in leadership, get a feeling when they know that the person that's working underneath them is smarter than them, It takes a mature person, it takes a strong personality to accept that the person that I'm working with may have more gifts and talents than I. And the reason why I say that he keeps on doing great things for me, when I go to church and I read in the word, and if you haven't followed me, if you've never heard me talk before, let me remind you that we are the church. You are the church. We are God's spokespersons. We are God's mouth, feet, hands, eyes, whatever you want to say on the earth. We are the vessels that God works through. The building where you congregate is literally just the building. So when I say why I go to church, I'm talking about me. I am not talking about a building. It's important to know that when God gives you a desire, hold on to it. Hold on to it. Sometimes it may not look as it seems. Sometimes the desired end, Jeremiah 29:11, you're like, God, I don't know if this makes sense. I don't know if this end is where I want to be. But when God spoke to Abram at the time, he told him to imagine a nation. Yeah, imagine a nation, imagination. And Abram looked out and he imagined a nation and he began to go to a land that God told him to go. He didn't have a final destination. He was just going after the voice of God and he was following after the call of God and he had to leave his family behind. When I think and reflect on that passage of scripture, sometimes in order for you to get the desire of your heart, you have to leave the environment that has been setting the parameters that you have gotten accustomed to. Yeah, the temperature, the climate that you have grown accustomed to has been set. And because the climate has been set, sometimes you are limiting yourself because the person around you doesn't have the same desire placed on them. When God places something on you that's bigger than your current circle, you have to get out of that circle. You can't stay in that circle. You can't stay in that place. And when you are unwilling to change, because when you are unwilling to change, you stifle your growth. When you are unwilling to go into a new place, you stifle your growth. When you are unwilling to get out of the driver's seat, you stifle your growth. When I look at the story of Abraham, I begin to reflect on where I am right now. And what does this have to do with the thermostat? And what does this have to do with the thermometer? When you are a thermometer, you're in charge of your environment. You get to set the temperature. You get to set the climate. You get to change the atmosphere. You get to decide whether this is a good place, a good temperature for me, if it's too hot, if it's too cold. You get to set all of that. But when you become a thermometer, that means you have more responsibility. You have more responsibility. When you're a thermostat, the only thing you're responsible for is telling somebody what has already been set, what has already been dictated. Many of us want to be a thermostat, but we don't want the responsibility to program the schedule. When you have a programmable thermostat, you are setting the time, at least on my thermostat. I have a 7-day programmable thermostat. And I have the responsibility to set what temperature I want my house to be in the morning, during the day, in the evening, and at nighttime. And I go in there and I make the setting and I determine what I want to see. But you have to be responsible enough. You have to be mature enough to handle that. God wants to expand your horizon because he wants to keep on doing great things for you. But you must come to a level of maturity where you allow God to change the climate that you're in. I was comfortable for many years, but I wasn't growing. I wasn't growing because I was comfortable. Yeah, because complacency, that kills your growth when you're so complacent. It really stunts your growth. To grow, you have to be uncomfortable. Because when you are uncomfortable, you begin many times to consult God and ask him for direction. So the reason why I say that God keeps on doing great things for me, there has been some desires that God has placed in my heart. I had no idea how these desires would come to pass. However, I kept seeking after God. I kept consulting after God. And when he would come to me, I would wake up and say, yeah, yeah. He would place it in my spirit. I'd be like, yeah, that's what I want to do. That's where I want to be. This is what I want to happen. But I had no idea how to get there. And then the moment came for me when this COVID situation began to break off at the beginning of 2019, when I'm not having employment. And at the moment, it looked as though that was not a desired end that I wanted. But God knew, in order for me to get where I needed to be, he needed to change the temperature. Because when the heat gets turned up, most of us get a little bit more serious and get a little bit more attentive, and we shouldn't need the temperature to be raised. But to be honest, some will never do what God has called them to do if the heat is never turned up. But the heat reveals what's inside of you. The heat lets you know what you're made of. The heat really lets you know, do you really love God? Because it's easy to love God when things are rosy. But when things are not rosy, will you still love God? Will you still seek after him? And the reason why I dive in his word, because in his word, I'm reminded of God's is consistently faithful. When I look in his word, I can see the stories of how people have been persecuted. I can look at the stories of how people have been falsely accused. I can look at the stories when people didn't have food. God always supplied. He always had a way of escape for them. When I read the word of God and when I study the word of God, I am comforted because I now see that he will never see his seed begging bread. And I didn't always know where ends were going to be met. I didn't always know, but I knew and I trusted and relied in that scripture, that Jeremiah 29:11, that God's thoughts and plans are good and not evil, to give me a hope and a future, to bring me an expected end. And I knew the desires that God had placed in my heart, that somehow, some way they would come to pass. And I know that God will open a door that no man can shut. So when man shut the door in my face, I didn't get melancholy. I knew that once one door shut, that God would have to open another door. So this message is today to remind you that God opens doors that no man can shut. And sometimes God allows doors to be shut because that environment is not good for you. That environment is too small for you. That place doesn't value you. That place is not maximizing your capability. It's very important to understand that God loves you, and God will never put you in a place that he didn't already know that you can handle it. God has sifted it, my friend. God has sifted your problem. So trust in the sifting process. So what has this got to do with he keeps doing great things for me? I love making videos. I love making videos. I love expressing myself through prose. I love being creative. And I was at a place where they didn't value my creativity. They didn't see that as an asset. Yes, I'm a degreed engineer. I've been a professional salesperson for 20 years. Yes, I do all of those technical things, but I'm still very creative. I now work at a position in a place where people value my creativity. Not only do they value my creativity, they ask for my creativity. I'm now in a place where I'm making productions for a multi-million dollar company. When people didn't want to pay me $50 for a production, now I'm producing for a company that's worth multi-million dollars, and they want it. God will give you the desires of your heart. Little did I know that I would be without a job for a season, only to be positioned in a place where I could be the thermostat. Yeah, there was a time when I was just the thermometer, and my company was dictating to me, saying you can't do this and you can't do that. And being a good employee and being a humble person, I just listened to them. Even though in my mind I thought, wow, we could make this look better. We could do more for that. But I stayed because I was complacent, and I stayed because the financial finances was good. I stayed because I was comfortable. But when God stretches you, Many times you become uncomfortable, but when you know that God loves you and you know that God has placed the desire, and I would say that, God, I want my voice to be known to the world. I want to have more reach. And I remember, I'm in many groups right now and I'm sharing, but I remember World Voice League, Altavis and Thea and Cheryl and Roz and Yolanda. There were people that supported me. There were people that purchased from me. There were opportunities given to me from those people that supported me. And they would say, you're doing a great job. But sometimes the people that are closest to you, you know, they're going to say you're doing a great job because they like you. Not that they wouldn't critique you. But now I'm in a position where the company that I work at, they love what I do. They want to pull on what I do. But I didn't know how I would ever be positioned to be a voice for a company. Yeah, I thought that making the video sometimes that God would have me produce, I would be like, God, I'm tired. I don't want to make another video. I don't want to do this. But how many of you know that the game isn't won on game day? The game is won on the practice field. The game is won in the off season. The game is won many weeks before the game is ever played. If you want to live for God, and if you want to be great for God, you must be prepared before the stage. Before you ever get on stage, there's going to be some preparation time. There's going to be some tough times. There's going to be some challenges times. And there's going to be opportunity for your faith to be tested, because you don't know what's in you until your faith is tested. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm telling you that when God brings a test, it should bring joy to your heart, because many times within those tests means elevation is coming. And I'm not talking about some financial blessing. That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about elevation in your spirit, elevation in your maturity. And if you continue to do the work, your gift will make room for you. But your gift will never make room for you if you're unwilling to work your gift. If you're unwilling to do the things when no one else is around, if you're unwilling to put in work and grind and put in the hours when someone doesn't necessarily think or see the value in the work that you do. I always say, someone's inability to see your value don't mean that you're not valuable. God has valued you, and God has gifted all of us with a gift. The question is, do you believe in your gift when there are naysayers saying they don't see the value in it? Will you still hold on to the vision? Will you still hold on to the dream? Will you still hold on to the thought when your life seems upside down? Will you still hold on and be committed to God when others are not being committed to you? I'm telling you that God keeps on doing great things. I just walked out of my building, and the owner of the company, he has two sons that work for the company, and they're bragging about the production that I produce. They want to know when I'm going to make the next production. They're asking me, do you want to be the face? Think about that. I was at a company that didn't value any of the skills that I didn't bring that wasn't through college. Yeah, they wanted to tap into the man-given training, but the God-given ability, they didn't want to tap into that. The company that I'm at right now, they're not even asking me, where did you learn that? Where did you get that skill? How did you get that skill? They weren't concerned about degree. Yes, I have a degree, but what they're asking me to do is a God-given gift and talent. Because God keeps doing great things for you, for me. And God will continue to do great things for you. But what you got to do is trust them when you can't trace them. You got to trust God even in the valley. You got to trust God even in a dark place. You got to trust God when you feel like you're underwater. You got to trust God when others tell you to walk away. You got to trust God. You have to be like Job. You have to be like Job. If friends tell you to walk away from God, don't walk away from God. If loved ones tell you to walk away from God, don't walk away from God. He's faithful. God is faithful. And when man shuts a door, that doesn't mean that God is shutting the door. This is what I would tell you. Seek after the answer you want. And don't stop until you get the answer that you want. If you're not seeking no's, then don't stop when you get a no. Stop when you get a yes. Many times we stop when we get a no, but if no is not the desired answer, then why stop? If God said, this is where you're going to be, don't stop until you get where God has promised you. Don't stop until you get to the place that God has promised you. The enemy of your faith, his job is to remind you of failures of your past. The enemy of your faith is trying to be the thermometer for your life. Understand that God has given us the ability to set our atmosphere. God has given us the ability to determine the course of our life. God has given us that ability. But if you don't realize that you have graduated from being a thermometer to a thermostat, then you'll never move. Stop allowing the enemy of your faith to dictate to you. God has come that you might have life and that you might have it more abundantly. That's what God has come to do. And beloved, above all, he wished that you would prosper and be in health, even as your soul prosper. God wants us to live a prosperous life. And some of us misconstrue a prosperous life to a life that doesn't require work. You're going to have to get your hands dirty. Sometimes you're going to have to get your feelings hurt. But most importantly, don't stop believing. Do not stop believing. If you're seeking a yes, keep going until you get that yes. You must never let go of God's unchanging hand and seek after the thing that God has placed in your heart. God keeps doing great things because he's a loving father. Sometimes bad things happen, but that don't mean that they're of God. Every good and perfect gift comes from him. We do have a real enemy, and he's trying to keep you off your game. He's trying to make you lose focus. Stay focused. Stay focused. That's what I want you to know, that God keeps doing great things because he is a loving God. He's a loving God. And sometimes we don't always know how to get to the end, but God does. Yeah, you don't always know how to get to the end, but God knows how to get you to a desired end. And I'm grateful that I'm closer to the desired end that God placed in my heart. Never stop believing and stay in an environment that keeps you hoping. Because faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not yet seen. Things hoped for, things hoped for. And people that lose hope can never get to faith. That's why it's important for you to be in an environment where they tell you to be hopeful. That's why it's important to stay in an environment where you're not influenced by all of the rhetoric. That's why it's important to stay in an environment where you understand that God has already placed a value on you and don't allow the enemy of your faith to devalue you. It's very important to stay in the environment. It's very important. And people will ask me all the time, man, they'll say, you going to church, you're talking about church and all this other stuff and everybody is fake. Listen, Jesus is real because I keep seeing him doing great things for me. The things that God has placed in my heart, I've seen them coming to pass in my life. In the last 3 years, promises that God spoke to me when I was a little kid, I'm seeing coming to pass. So I'm not going to turn back. I'm not going to let go. And I'm not going to be silent. I'm not going to be silent. I'm not going to let somebody push me off my square and tell me that this is fake. No, I'm just not going to let somebody do that because God keeps doing great things for me. Why would I turn back when God placed desires in my heart when I was 11 and 12 that now I see at age 44? Why would I turn back from that? But what I do know, I had no idea how I would get there. I didn't know that there would be valleys. I didn't know that sometimes there would be peaks. I didn't know that I would see death. I didn't know that I would lose loved one. I didn't know that I would lose jobs. I didn't know that I would have physical injuries. I didn't know that you would go through stages where you felt unworthy. I didn't know all of that. But my worth is in the words that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. He gave his only begotten son. My value is in the word is that he loved me. He cared for me. That's where I get my value from. So that's why I keep going to church, and that's why I keep diving in, and that's why I keep doing the things that I do. Because he keeps doing great things for me. As I stated a few weeks ago, when my tire blew out, it's in the little things when you give thanks to God that he'll reward you when you recognize and understand that this is not your doing, it's his doing. I just would encourage you to find a place that can keep your hope up. Yeah, to keep your hope up. To keep your hope up. We see every day places that don't seem hopeful. We see every day places that all they speak is confusion. Don't be entertained by confusion, because when you walk in confusion, you'll never get to the place that God has for you. As long as you stand in the umbrella of confusion, you can never get to the place that God has called you to be. I'm very well, Elizabeth. You can never get to the place that God calls you to be without his guidance, without his leading, without a connection. You can never get there. Because you can't expect mere man to have the heart of God. Only a regenerated mind, only a renewed spirit can have the heart of God. You got to opt into God's system. You can't have the heart of God saying, because I went to college, that doesn't give you the heart of God. That does not give you the heart of God. Man is selfish. Yes, it's in our nation's nature to be selfish. We understand what the unregenerated man will give you. It will produce greed. It will produce capitalism. It doesn't produce humanity. God keeps doing great things for his people. But don't expect man without God to treat you like the man and woman of God that you are. Don't expect a man that doesn't have God to necessarily value you. And I'm not saying that just because someone doesn't have God that they're not a good person. That's not what I'm saying. But what I'm letting you know is that man without God will put himself first. Can you tell me something? What would you like to tell me? You're welcome to type it on the screen. I just need you to understand that God keeps on doing great things for me. And because God keeps on doing great things for me, I will share it. And hopefully, my testimony will encourage you to seek after God. That's the whole reason for me talking about why I go to church. It's just to get you to understand that you need to value yourself enough that you develop a relationship with your Creator. That you value yourself enough to understand that your gift will make room for you if you work it. You must work the gift. You must work your gift. You must work it. That's the bottom line, you must work it. But in closing, I would say that God placed a desire in my heart. And I had no way of knowing how I would get there. But I can tell you today that I'm one step closer. I'm one step closer to the goal of what God has placed in my heart. So if God has given you a thought, if God has made you a promise, Don't stop until you see the promise. Stop stopping for answers that God didn't give. Man can shut a door, but that don't mean that God has shut the door. Man can say no. That don't mean that God says no. Man can say it's not possible, but the word says all things are possible to them that believe. So I encourage you to stay in an environment. Stay in an environment until your hope catches fire. Till your hope catches fire. Because when your hope catches fire, you begin to write down and make a plan. And when you begin to write down your plans, your visions, your dreams, your aspirations can be actualized and realized in your life. Those things will happen when you begin to move forward, but it never happens if you have no hope. Remember, God called his children to be thermostats and not thermometers. Stop dabbling in the world system and only reporting what the world says. Understand that God has called us to be leaders. God has called us to set the atmosphere. God has called us to make changes in the earth. God has called us to be his ambassador. And the only way that you can know what the Father wants to do, you have to get close to the Father's heart. And I don't know how you get close to the Father's heart. I don't know how you can get close to the Father's heart if you're not hollowing out time to get in his word and allow him to speak to you. So I encourage you again, find a place where your soul can be fed. If this message has blessed you, I ask that you share it out. But this is Michael Gibson, and that's why I go to church, because he keeps doing great things for me. Stay blessed and enjoy your day.